Want to earn up to 1,000 HBARs and also test out the Hedera Hashgraph network? Well, in this video, we're going to take a look at the recently announced community testing program and also ways that you can get involved with it. Let's get started. Hi, everyone. It's the Gossip Guy, your trusted source for news and developments from the world powered by Hashgraph. Recently, Hedera Hashgraph announced their community testing program, an effort designed to allow the community to participate in the testing of the mainnets and testnets prior to the launch of open access later on this year. The best part is that users will have the opportunity to earn up to 1,000 HBARs through their involvement. The program will center around testing of micropayments through the recently released Hedera wallet and some sample applications, including the Daily Timestamp, a content site that's accessible via a web browser plugin that powers micropayments. So to gather further insights on this, I had the opportunity to sit down with Brady Gentile from the Hedera Hashgraph team to learn more about the program, where to get started, and some other topics relevant to the community. I hope you enjoy this video, and if you find it to be helpful, make sure to leave a like. Okay, so Brady, thanks for taking the time to speak with us today. And I guess before we get started here, do you mind providing us a brief introduction to yourself?
Sure. Thanks so much for having me on here, Billy. My name is Brady Gentile. I am a product marketing manager at Hedera Hashgraph, and super excited today to talk to you guys a little bit about the community testing program that we've just recently launched.
Great. Thank you for this. All right. So let's kick things off here. So can you tell us a little more about the community testing program?
Sure. So the community testing program is a mainnet Hedera testing program for a community where folks can make micropayments and earn up to 1,000 HBARs for doing so. And the way that works is you sign up using our newly released Hedera portal, download the wallet, connect it to a browser extension, and then using the account that you created with your wallet, you can make those micropayments on a news website that we've set up called dailytimestamp.com.
Awesome. Thanks for that overview. All right. So if you don't mind me kind of shifting things here and kind of getting a little more into the details, I guess, where do users go to get started? You know, for example, you know, what are the steps involved for setting up your account, creating a wallet, and then I guess ultimately participating in the testing program?
Yeah, absolutely. So as I mentioned before, the starting point for anyone who wants to join the community testing program is going to be the Hedera portal. And that can be found at portal.hedera.com. That's going to be your starting point in creating a Hedera portal login. And once you do that, you'll go through the process of verifying your identity. It's a KYC process that at this point in time, anyone who's joining the program is required to go through. We work with OnFido for that process. Once you do that, you'll have some instructions that you receive through email as well as within the portal that walk you through getting your wallet set up on a mobile device, and that's iOS or Android. And you're essentially connecting a public key that you've created in your wallet to the Hedera portal in order to generate an account ID, which is the account ID that you'll place back into your Hedera wallet and use as the primary account for the Hedera cryptocurrency HBAR. From that point, what you can then do is download the Hedera browser extension on Google Chrome. And that's going to be the tool that you use in order to make micropayments on the dailytimestamp.com website, which is a new news website that we've put together that has a number of different articles about micropayments, about Hedera Hashgraph. There's some content from our recent developer conference, Hedera 18. And we're going to be updating it frequently. And when you view those articles, you actually use the HBAR cryptocurrency to make a micropayment and help us test the network. And that's sort of a brief overview of sort of how you get set up. The best place to go, though, like I said, to get started is going to be portal.hedera.com.
Great. Thanks for that explanation. And I guess with the highlights of the program out of the way here, I know that there's some other topics that users and the community are interested in or kind of worth clarifying. So with that being said, if you don't mind, I have a few additional questions to kind of fire off here.
starting first with the whole account setup and the know your customer or KYC process. I know some folks in the community have had some questions on the purpose for this. Thus, do you mind sharing some further clarification on kind of why you guys are doing this, and I guess why is it important for the initial setup, you know, for the account?
Sure. So doing the community testing period, anyone who's receiving HBARs from Hedera or through the use of the Hedera network, they have to go through this KYC process that you mentioned, identity verification. And really what it is it's a sanctioned screening process, and it's just to ensure that we and everyone else are applying, complying with the applicable laws. When there is open access to the network, though, I mean, our goal is for everyone to be able to build on us quickly, easily, and with no friction. So as we continue to evaluate our position and work with regulators to ensure compliance, we're going to try and meet the needs of the community and, you know, the vision of the company.
Yep, makes sense. All right, so moving along here, and I guess this kind of comes as a personal question of mine. So with the early access to the mainnet and the community testing program, how many accounts can users set up at this stage? You know, for example, is it one account per user, or can we set up multiple accounts during the program?
So at this point in time, our wallet only supports the creation of one default account. But in the future, I would imagine that we will support having more than one account.
Okay, thanks for clarifying that. And I guess to just for the benefit of our viewers here and to kind of summarize what you just said there. So right now, it's going to be one account per user during the testing program. However, once open access of the mainnet is made available, then users will be able to set up multiple accounts. So I just thought it'd be worthwhile to just kind of point that out. Alrighty, so moving along here, I wanted to ask you about the Maenette cards. And I guess these were the cards that many folks in the community had received during the Hedera 18 Developer Conference this past October. So as I kind of understood it, with the account setup and the wallet creation, users had the ability to enter in the code at the back of their mainnet cards in order to claim some sort of allocation of HBARs that also kind of tied into the community testing program. So I guess my question to you is, how do the mainnet cards and also the testing program interrelate with each other? And I guess, what can cardholders expect as an outcome of the program?
Great question. So you're right. There are a number of folks who attended the Hedera 18 conference in Dallas or any of our hackathons globally. And if they did, they will have received these HBAR early access mainnet cards. The majority of people who receive them, they're going to be able to have their token cap go from the standard 1,000 tokens up to 4,000 tokens. And so when they go through the process of doing the micropayment transactions, the max cap then that they can earn is significantly more than the general population. I know that over time too, we're likely going to extend the testing program and allow for other types of activities to be involved to earn HBAR. So this phase right now is just the first one, and includes the dailytimestamp.com and the browser extension at this time.
Great. And I guess we should also note too that you know, cardholders have until the end of February 1st, 2019 to activate those cards. I know you guys had recently pointed this out in some of the community discussion channels, so I thought it was worthwhile to just kind of point that out. All right, so moving on here, the community testing program, you know, I know it's going to serve as an opportunity for Hedera to showcase some of the features of the platform, you know, specifically around micropayments. So I guess with those, you know, tools and, you know, features that users are going to be testing, you know, on the mainnet, I guess, is there going to be any opportunity for the community to also have access to those, you know, tools even after the program's over?
Yeah, great question. So it is very important to us that developers can easily get started with the Hedera Hashgraph platform and start building decentralized applications and game-changing applications. And one of the things that we've done to try and help enable that even more is open source some of these tools that we've created. So The Hedera wallet that's released on iOS and Android is a fully open source application. The daily timestamp is going to be open source as well. You can browse through the code. And it's Apache 2 license. You can take that and use it in your applications. And then the third thing is the micropayments Hedera browser extension for Google Chrome. That's also going to be open source. All of the code is available for three of these things on github.com/hashgraph.
Wow. Thanks for sharing this. And this is some great news. I know that some of the developers in the community will also look to probably leverage some of these resources for their own individual projects. You know, basically this way they don't have to start from scratch.
That's right. We want to have a number of examples for developers to be able to use to go off and build their applications. And in addition to those examples, too, I don't think I mentioned, but our SDK is open source as well. And we have that in a number of languages, Java, Python, Go, C, Rust, and we're continuing to do that.
I guess with all this said, you know, first I want to say thank you for taking the time to sit down with me today. And, you know, I guess before I let you go here, is there anything else that you want to say to the community?
Thanks so much for having me on as well. Super excited to be able to speak to the community directly here. Final thing, closing words is we are incredibly excited for everyone to get started earning cryptocurrency, helping test the main network, and building applications on testnets and on the Hedera Hashgraph platform. And we can't wait to see what you guys all build.
Great. So once again, Brady, I really appreciate your time today. And I guess we'll all look forward for the months ahead as we all help to test out the Hedera mainnet.
Absolutely. We are we're super excited for everyone to start testing the network and start earning some HBAR cryptocurrency.
And lastly, before we conclude this video, I want to leave you with some resources in regards to all the topics we covered today. First is the Hedera portal at portal.hedera.com, the starting point for where you can set up your account on the mainnet. Next is the Hedera Wallet app, which you can download from either the iOS App Store or Android Play Store. After you have the account set up and synced it with your wallet, you can install your Hedera browser plugin, which will provide you access to the daily timestamp and can be found via the Google Chrome Store. At any point, if you encounter any issues, be sure to visit the Hedera FAQ page at help.hedera.com, which includes specific guidance and resources about the portal, wallet, and also the community testing program. Finally, if you have any questions throughout the course of the program, be sure to visit hashgraph.org, the community website for all things Hashgraph, or the developer community on Discord.
So that's it for this video. I hope you find it to be helpful. And if you want to stay posted on further news and developments from the world powered by Hashgraph and the Hedera ecosystem, be sure to subscribe to my channel, The Gossip Guy. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.